The topic I'm going to discuss the conceptual framework of research. Conceptual framework is very important in social science research. Here the researcher getting an idea of what are the variables and what are the constructs he can focus based on its conceptual understanding. Contents which include difficulties faced by the researchers in developing framework for a study and the purpose of conceptual framework, sources from which these frameworks are derived and how conceptual framework are presented in thesis. So literature definitions of conceptual framework. Some authors view conceptual and theoretical framework as synonymous. But in researchers also there is a confusion regarding the both terms, conceptual and theoretical framework. Some of the scholars says that this is same and we can feel that this is different. Some studies we cannot find that conceptual and theoretical framework. Actually we can we cannot find conceptual and theoretical framework in some of the studies. It provides an orientation of the study. The author and the reader will understand how the study contributes the body of existing knowledge. It tells how the study design and methodology meet rigorous research standards. A conceptual framework is incredibly important because if a scholar did not undergo this kind of conceptual and theoretical framework, he may skip some most important predominant variables, and these variables may be noted by the expert person during the time of evaluation. That will be a very critical point of that work. So now we can look on the differences between conceptual framework and theoretical framework. A theoretical framework in a study based on an existing theory or theories, for example theory of motivation. The conceptual framework on the other hand is something you can develop yourself based on this theory. So the conceptual framework is the second step after the theoretical framework. So in theoretical framework we actually do the literature review process, and based on the literature review process some conceptual understanding the scholar will develop based on the literature review or theoretical understanding. That conceptual framework lead for the development of constructs which are very crucial for the development of questionnaires. So conceptual framework is developed by the researcher to solve a particular problem that he wants to find solution, whereas theoretical framework is based on theories or general representation of relationship between various things. Conceptual framework assists in finding way to solve the problem. Theoretical framework helps in relating your identified specific problem in general. This slide shows the argument for conceptual framework. It determines the importance of intended audience of the study. So when we do a thesis or when we write a paper, we have to have a clear understanding on the audience who read the paper, and the constructs we set which are important to some audience. So that idea should be framed initially. It demonstrates alignment with the research questions, data collection, data analysis, as well as the use of procedures to conduct the study. So this conceptual framework provide a base for the data collection and the framing of research questions and data analysis, as well as the use of procedures to conduct study. Recently we have seen many research studies they couldn't undertake the literature review as well as the conceptual understanding, so that in final at the time of open defense or the evaluation process some of the expert may be noted their criticism on the way main constructs they have avoided or they haven't undertake the major areas of the study which were excluded completely. That will lead for the wrong conclusions. So Miles 2014 research should promote spending significant time for the development of conceptual framework. This process encourages a closer assessment of how study's variables related, how study participants are characterized, and how data collection instruments are selected. So this this conceptual understanding help how a study's variables are related, how participants are characteristics, and how data collection instruments are selected. So this slide discusses how to do theoretical framework, a step-by-step process of theoretical framework, which should be done by all the researchers. So identify the theories connected with the study. First of all, the research scholar have to identify the theories connected with the study. So somebody may argue that there are no theories related with the work, but theories in this sense means the previous literature or previous papers, something like that. So that should be the theories. So the scholar should take more emphasis on the finding out of the previous literature. Then identify the specific theory. Once the lot of theories have identified, and the scholar next step is the scholar have to stick on the specific theory and includes the sources and the major hypothesis framed and test for each theory. There are a lot of theories, but the scholar have to stick on a particular theory which is closely related with his or her study, and what were the hypotheses framed and tested for each theory. Then identify the theory selected for the study. This includes review of previous studies using that theory. Then state how the study contributes the existing body of knowledge related to that theory. So this is a process, theoretical framework. Theoretical framework, I already pointed out that the researcher have to look on the literature review, previous studies based on some keywords. That time the researcher have to look on the major publishers. He can look on the journal indexes like Web of Science, Scopus, ABDC index, and he can look on the major publishers like Taylor and Francis, Springer, Wiley, okay, IndoScience. These are the major publishers, journals, articles based on the keywords. Then identify specific theories. A lot of theories available, then he look on the specific theories or theoreticians. Then select a theory related to the study. He should select a theory related to the study and relationship of the theory to the study. So this is a process of conceptual framework. So purpose of conceptual framework. Conceptual framework there are purposes: argumentation, explanation, generation. Then argumentation divided into importance of study, appropriate and rigorous design and methods. Then explanation, key factor relationships, and generation, problem, research questions, data collection, data analysis, findings and interpretation. So everything is depends on the conceptual framework. If a scholar missed the conceptual understanding or conceptual framework, he may not complete the work with 100% accuracy. So this slide explained the sources of conceptual framework. The conceptual framework sources consist of experience, literature, and theoretical framework. Experience is very important. The experience means he can consult with the colleagues as well as faculties and check out the experience with that particular area, and he can go for the previous literature, as already pointed out that he can go for the theoretical framework, and all these things provide a better understanding of the conceptual framework. So this is the sources of conceptual framework.